Hello again, my dear students. Let us continue our civics class, Social Justice and the Marginalized. Chapter 31, page number 249 to 250. Today, let us discuss the provisions in the Constitution to safeguard the interests of the marginalized groups. Social inequality and poverty. And finally, the affirmative action. First, let's see provisions in the Constitution. The following measures were undertaken for the betterment of the marginalized groups. People cannot be discriminated against in the use of public facilities like shops, hotels, and malls. They can also use common wells, tanks, roads, and other public infrastructure. Untouchability has been abolished. Practicing untouchability is a punishable offense. Titles denoting privilege like Nawab and Raja have been abolished. People can only attach academic and military titles to their names. People have the right to reside in any part of the country. However, this right has some restriction to protect the interests of tribal groups. The National Commission for the Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes was constituted to protect the interests of the marginalized groups. Reservations for SCs, STs, and OBCs have been created in central, state, and local legislative bodies. Moving on to social inequality and poverty. In India, economic assets like land and cattle had been concentrated in the hands of the upper caste. They had exclusive access to education and job opportunities. The lower caste had been confined to low-paying occupations and had no chance to improve their lot. Generation after generation suffered poverty and indignity. Therefore, economic inequality has a strong link to social divisions. Tribal groups have been displaced from their homelands by development projects undertaken by the government. Sometimes they have been offered no rehabilitation or little compensation. They too are stricken by poverty and lack of opportunities. Even after reservations have been implemented, a vast majority of neglected sections continue to suffer from the ill effects of marginalization. Affirmative action. Reservations in education and employment opportunities have been provided to the SCs, STs, and OBCs as a tool to undo centuries of discrimination and bring them on par with the rest of society. It is an attempt to realize the true spirit of the right to equality. This kind of policy comes under the umbrella of affirmative action. A certain quota of seats in government-aided educational institutions and in government jobs has been reserved for SCs, STs, and OBCs. However, reservation policies have met with strong opposition from certain quarters. They argue that reservation will lead to the deterioration of the quality of students and professionals. It is essential to remember that a large number of marginalized people still live lives of complete misery, doing jobs considered unfit for the general population. Till the time their plight improves, reservation will continue to be an important tool for improvement. Let us conclude our class for now. I would like to request all of you to read your textbook, chapter 31, from page number 249 to 250. Thank you.